Welcome to Everyday Cooking. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, please click the subscribe button and the bell icon to stay connected, and it is absolutely free. As the first recipe, let us see how to prepare Andhra style spicy chicken curry.
For this, first we are going to marinate the chicken. Take 1 kg of chicken. To this, add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, the required amount of salt, and 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Give a nice mix. Marination part is over. Let this sit at least for 1/2 hour. Here we have used country chicken, which will take extra time to cook than the normal chicken, so we are going to use the cooker. Transfer this into a pressure cooker. Add 2 tablespoons of oil and 2 cups of water. You have to pressure cook this for 3 whistles, and before this get cooked, we'll move on to the gravy. Add 3 tablespoons of oil, preferably groundnut oil. To this, add 2 bay leaves, 4 cardamoms, and 5 cloves. Saute this for 2 minutes. Once this is sauteed, we'll add 2 cups of chopped onions. Give a nice saute, the onions has to turn lightly brown. Once the onions are cooked properly, you can add around 4 to 5 green chilies. And to this, add a tablespoon of ginger garlic paste and give a nice saute. Saute this until the raw smell goes off. So after 2 minutes, you can add all the masalas. Add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 3 teaspoons of chili powder. Usually Andhra curries will be more spicy, so if you want, you can reduce the chili powder. Saute this for about a minute and close this and cook till the oil loses out. This is perfect. By this time our chicken is also ready, so separate the chicken stock and add the chicken. Mix everything well and saute this for about a minute. Now add the chicken stock. To this, let us add 2 teaspoons of garam masala. Give a nice mix. The chicken has to get cooked in this masala well, so close this and cook for 5 minutes in medium flame. This is after 5 minutes, add a cup of water. To this we are going to add a coconut masala paste, and for the masala paste you need 1/4 cup of coconut, 5 cashew nuts, 1 teaspoon of poppy seeds and 1 teaspoon of sesame seeds. Grind everything into a fine paste and add into this. Mix everything well. The raw smell of the coconut has to go off, so close this and cook in medium flame for about 15 minutes. This is after 15 minutes, it is almost ready. As a final touch, add few chopped coriander leaves and few chopped curry leaves. Mix it and let it be on the flame for about a minute, and then you can switch off the flame. Our Natukoli curry is ready. Transfer this into another bowl and add few more coriander leaves.
The next recipe is chicken lollipop.
For the recipe, I have taken 4 leg pieces of chicken. To this, add the required amount of salt, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper powder, 1/2 teaspoon chicken masala, If you don't have chicken masala, you can go for garam masala. 1 teaspoon of finely chopped ginger, 1 teaspoon of finely chopped green chilies, 1 teaspoon of finely chopped garlic, 2 teaspoons of corn flour, 2 teaspoons of all-purpose flour, that is maida, few chopped spring onions, few chopped coriander leaves and few chopped mint leaves. Now everything has to get bind well, so add little water and give a nice mix. The chicken has to get a nice coating with all the masalas and the flour. After marinating your chicken, leave it for half an hour. After half an hour, you can deep fry this in hot oil. Keep the flame between low and medium and the oil should be hot. Flip all the sides and cook properly. The chicken is ready, we can take it out now. The next recipe is chicken manchurian. For this, let us take a quarter kg of boneless chicken. To this, add little salt, 2 teaspoons of corn flour, 2 teaspoons of all-purpose flour, that is maida. The chicken has to get coated well, so add little water and give a nice mix. So here the marination is over, let us deep fry the chicken. Deep fry the chicken in hot oil and in medium flame. The chicken is ready, we can take it out now. Set the fried chicken aside, next we are going to make a masala. Now pour some oil in a pan. To this add half a teaspoon of finely chopped ginger. Half a teaspoon of finely chopped garlic, 1 teaspoon of finely chopped green chilies, few curry leaves, 1 to 1.5 teaspoons of finely chopped spring onions and half a teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Saute this well. The raw smell of the ginger garlic paste has to go off, so saute this for about a minute or two. Next, add few cashew nuts. Fry the cashew nuts well and add little water. You can add around 1/4 cup of water. Let us add the required amount of salt and let us start adding the masalas. Half a teaspoon of chili powder, half a teaspoon of coriander powder, half a teaspoon of pepper powder, half a teaspoon of garam masala, cashew nut paste 2 teaspoons, and 2 teaspoons of curd. Saute this for about a minute. Next, let us start adding the sauces. 1 teaspoon of tomato sauce, half a teaspoon of green chili sauce, half teaspoon of soya sauce, and finally half a teaspoon of vinegar. Give a nice mix, and if your masala is dry, you can add a little water. Saute this for about 2 to 3 minutes. When the oil starts oozing out, you can add the fried chicken. Give a nice mix. To this, add fresh chopped coriander leaves and about half a teaspoon of pepper powder. Coriander leaves and pepper powder will give a nice flavor for the recipe. The dry version of chicken manchurian is ready. Next, let us see a street food style chicken fry. For this, I am going to use 1/2 kg of chicken. Clean the chicken well and drain the water. To this, add 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1.5 teaspoons of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, 1 teaspoon soya sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of green chili sauce, the required amount of salt, and 1/4 cup of curd. Mix everything well. We are going to marinate the chicken well and keep it in the refrigerator for an hour. Keeping in the refrigerator will make the masalas bind well with the chicken. Here the marination part is over. Let us keep this in the refrigerator for an hour. This is ready now. After taking the chicken out of the refrigerator, add 3 tablespoons of corn flour. Add the corn flour in portions and give a nice mix. So here our chicken is ready to be fried. Shallow fry the chicken in hot oil in medium flame. Turn both sides and cook properly. Here the chicken has to be cooked well and the outer layer should become crispy. Always cook the chicken between low and medium flame. This will help the chicken to cook evenly. Here the chicken is ready, the outer layer seems to be crispy, so we can take it out. Our first set is over, let us finish the second set. So here the chicken is ready. In the same oil, fry some handful of curry leaves. This will give you a very nice flavor. And when you have it with the chicken, the taste will be very, very nice. Next is chicken dum biryani in cooker. For this, first we are going to cook the basmati rice. Take around 6 cups of water, in which add 2 bay leaves, 3 to 4 cardamom, 1 small stick of cinnamon, 3 to 4 cloves, few mint leaves and the required amount of salt. Once the water starts boiling, you can add the basmati rice. I have taken 1.5 cups of basmati rice. By the time the rice cooks, let us prepare the masala. Pour some oil in a pan. To this, add the whole spices, a small piece of cinnamon, 3 to 4 cloves and around 3 to 4 cardamom. To this, add 2 bay leaves and give a nice saute for about a minute. Next is green chilies, you can add 1 or 2. Next, add about 3 medium sized onions, it has to be sliced. Saute the onions well, it has to turn translucent and has to become slightly brown. The onions has changed its color, at this stage you can add 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste and then give a nice saute. Raw smell of the ginger garlic paste has to go. Next is few chopped mint leaves and few chopped coriander leaves. Saute this for about a minute or two. Now the masalas, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder and 1 teaspoon of chili powder. Saute this for another 2 to 3 minutes. Now let us add the chicken, 1/2 kg of cleaned chicken. Don't add any water to this, the chicken will leave water while cooking. That is sufficient for the chicken to get cooked. Add the required amount of salt. Chicken has to get cooked well, so close this and cook properly. Open and saute this in between. Almost the chicken got cooked. At this stage, add 2 or 3 chopped tomatoes. Close this and cook for another 2 or 3 minutes. Before the chicken gets cooked, we'll see what happened to the rice. The rice is also ready. It has to get half cooked. That's it. You can switch off the flame. Now remove the excess water. So here you can see the rice is half cooked. It should not get mashed easily. Set this aside. Next we'll move on to the masala. The masala is also ready. Now let us get ready for the dum. Take the pressure cooker, pour some ghee in it. The first layer is going to be chicken masala. Next is rice. Now repeat the process. In between you can add few chopped coriander leaves or chopped mint leaves, or you can add even fried cashew nuts. Your last layer has to be rice. Top this with few coriander leaves and close the pressure cooker. I'm going to put dum here, but I'm going to keep it in the direct flame only. Use the whistle. Keep it in the low flame so that your cooker will not whistle. This has to be on the flame for another 15 to 20 minutes in low flame. Make sure you cook in low flame. Only if you cook in low flame, your cooker will not whistle. Just give a light mix. Here our biryani is ready. Hope you. The next recipe will be chicken majestic. For the recipe, I have taken 250 grams of boneless chicken. And we are going to marinate the chicken first. Add 2 teaspoons of corn flour. 2 teaspoons of maida, that is all purpose flour. Required amount of salt. And little water. Give a nice mix. After coating the chicken, deep fry them in hot oil. Fry them in medium flame until it turns golden brown. This is perfect. We can take it out now. Set this aside. Next we'll move on to the masala. Pour some oil in a pan. To this add a teaspoon of finely chopped ginger, a teaspoon of finely chopped garlic, 2 teaspoons of chopped spring onions and few cashew nuts. Fry the cashew nuts well. Once the cashew nuts are fried, add few big pieces of onions and a teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Saute this until the raw smell of the ginger garlic paste goes off. To this next add 3 tablespoons of beaten curd and 3 tablespoons of cashew nut paste. Give a nice saute for a few minutes. After sauteing this for a minute or two, we can add the masalas. Before adding the masalas, add the required amount of salt and then the masalas. Half a teaspoon of chili powder, half teaspoon of pepper powder, half a teaspoon of coriander powder and a quarter teaspoon of garam masala. Give a nice saute, the masala smell has to go off. This is little dry now, so let us add some water. Add little water and give a nice saute until the oil oozes out. You can see that the oil has oozed out, so this is perfect. At this stage, we can add the chicken. Now mix everything well. The masala and chicken has combined well. At this stage, add few spring onions and few coriander leaves. Give a mix and switch off the flame. So here our chicken majestic is ready. Do give a try. This will taste so good. Next, let us see a hotel style chicken 65. For this, I have taken a quarter kg of chicken. This is boneless chicken. To this, add the required amount of salt, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon of chicken masala, 1/4 teaspoon of pepper powder, 1 teaspoon of finely chopped garlic, 1/2 teaspoon of finely chopped ginger, few chopped spring onions, few coriander leaves, 2 teaspoons of corn flour, 2 teaspoons of all-purpose flour, that is maida, and finally 2 teaspoons of curd or yogurt. Give a nice mix. We are going to give this rest for at least 1/2 hour. After 1/2 hour to 1 hour, you can deep fry this in hot oil. Cook this in low to medium flame. So here one side is cooked. Let us flip this. Cook this until it is golden brown. The chicken is ready here. We can take it out now. Our chicken 65 is ready. Hope you like the recipe. We'll join you in another interesting recipe, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.